Hello students, today we are going to do the numericals of third B exercise, that is about pulley and pulley system. The important formulas used for solving the numericals of pulley and pulley system are: mechanical advantage is equal to load upon effort. Mechanical advantage which is equal to load upon effort. So this is one of the formulas. Then efficiency is equal to mechanical advantage upon velocity ratio. Then in the case of block and tackle system, in the case of block and tackle system of pulleys, velocity ratio is equal to number of pulleys. Then in question, it is also asked to mark the tension in the string, calculate the mechanical advantage. This all we will see in detail while solving the numericals. First question, a woman draws water from a well using a fixed pulley. The mass of bucket and water together is 6 kg. Mass 6 kg. Mass of bucket and water together is 6 kg. And acceleration due to gravity is given as 10 meter per second square. So what is the load? Load is equal to mg. So we will find the load in Newton. In Newton, if you have to find the force, then we have to find mg. 6 into 10, which is equal to 60 Newton. Then question, the force applied by women is 70 Newton. Effort is equal to 70 Newton. So this much is given. So we are asked to calculate the mechanical advantage. So what is the formula to find the mechanical advantage? Mechanical advantage is equal to load upon effort. Load divided by effort. Load is 60 Newton upon 70 Newton. Newton and Newton cancel, 0 and 0 cancel, 6 upon 7, which is equal to 0.832. 0.857. 0.857. So this is the answer. Now, doing the third question. In a block and tackle system consisting of three pulleys, a load of 75 kg force is raised with an effort of 25 kg force. The load is equal to 75 kg force. Effort is equal to 25 kg force. Then, first of all, find the mechanical advantage. So, what is the formula to find mechanical advantage? Load upon effort. 75 kgf upon 25 kgf. Kgf, kgf cancel. 25 upon 75 is equal to 3. So, this is the mechanical advantage. Mechanical advantage is equal to 3. Second part, we have to find the velocity ratio. So what is the formula to find the velocity ratio of block and tackle system? So velocity ratio of block and tackle system is number of pulleys. The velocity ratio is equal to number of pulleys. So which is equal to block and tackle system of 3 pulleys. So velocity ratio is equal to 3. Now third part, we have to find the efficiency. So efficiency is equal to MA upon velocity ratio. MA upon VR. And if you have to express efficiency in percentage, if you have to express efficiency in percentage, you have to multiply with the 100%. MA is 3, velocity ratio is 3. 3 and 3 cancel, so we get it as a 100%. Efficiency is equal to 100%. Here we have, for finding the mechanical advantage, we have written the formula load upon effort. For finding the velocity ratio, we have written the formula. Velocity ratio of block and tackle system is equal to number of pulleys. And for finding efficiency, efficiency is equal to MA upon VR into 100%. These are all very simple numericals. You have to just substitute, write the formula and substitute the values. So we will get the answer. Now we are doing question number 5. A block and tackle system of 5 pulleys. When you have to make a block and tackle system of 5 pulleys, so 5 is an odd number. When you make an odd number of pulley system, the number of pulleys in the upper block must be 1 more than the number of pulleys in the lower block. So in question can be asked, draw a block and tackle system of 5 pulleys or 7 pulleys. When you make a block and tackle system of odd number of pulleys, the number of pulleys in the upper blocks must be 1 more than the number of pulleys in the lower block. And while making also you have to be careful. Now I am going to make the upper block. So the upper one which I make here, that must be little bigger. The next one size should be smaller than this one. And the next one size should be again smaller than this one. So this way. Okay. Here there is a axis of rotation. So this is the upper block, and upper block must be always fixed. Now while making the lower block, so it is a block and tackle system of 5 pulleys, so in upper block I have made 3 pulleys, and in lower block we have to make 2 pulleys. So while making the lower block, the first one should be smaller in size, and the next one size must be bigger than this one. So it is made in such a way that this one size is bigger, then this one size is smaller than this, and the next one size is smaller than this one. Then while coming to the lower block, this upper one size is smaller, the next one size is comparatively bigger, and so on. So that when while putting the strings, then the strings on touch each other. That is why it is made in this manner. Now, First word is mark the diagram. Mark the diagram, the direction of load and effort. For before that, we have to make the string. So this is load. The direction of load is vertically downward. So we have to make the what we have to do? We have to make the string. So for making the strings, so in the case of odd number of pulleys, odd number of pulleys. So we have to start the string from the lower block. We have to start the string from the lower block. So we start the string from here, the lower block, hook of the lower block. Tying here, starting from here. Then passing through the groove of this one, then coming to this pulley, then passing through the groove of this one, then going to the next one, passing through the groove of this one, then coming to the next one, passing through the groove of this one, then going to the next one, passing through the groove and applying the effort here. Okay, this is the diagram. First part is to mark the direction of load. This is the load. The direction of load is downward. Effort is also downward. Now, second part. If the load is raised by 1 meter, through what distance will the effort move? First of all, we will write the velocity ratio. Second part we are doing. So first part is marking the direction of load and effort. That is vertically downward. Second part, velocity. What is the formula of velocity ratio of block and tackle system? Velocity ratio is equal to number of pulleys. So what is its velocity ratio? Its velocity ratio is equal to 5. And there is also formula velocity ratio, displacement of effort upon displacement of load. Velocity ratio is equal to displacement of effort upon displacement of load. So in this case, velocity ratio is equal to 5. And in question it is given that load is raised by 1 meter. Load is raised by 1 meter. What is the displacement of effort? We substitute the values in this one. 5 is equal to displacement of effort upon 1. Cross multiplying 5 into 1 meter. That is equal to displacement of effort. So displacement of effort is equal to 5 meter. So this is second part. Now third part. State the number of strands or tackle supporting the load. Number of strands of, so that is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So C part also answer is a 5. Now, what is the mechanical advantage of the system? What is the mechanical advantage of the system? Mechanical advantage is load upon effort. So to calculate the load in terms of tension, that we count these all tensions. So this tension is not counted in load. So total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Load is equal to 5 times tension and effort is equal to this. Effort is equal to this one. So this also we get it as a 5. So this is the solution of this question. Now doing question number 6. A pulley system has a velocity ratio 3 and an efficiency 80%. Velocity ratio is equal to 3. and efficiency is equal to 80%. First part, draw a label diagram of this pulley system. Draw a label diagram of this pulley system. As I said, draw a block and angle system of three pulleys. So, 3 is an odd number, so the number of pulleys in the upper block must be 2 and the lower block must be 1. So, drawing upper block. So, in upper block, there must be 2 pulleys. And the upper block is fixed. And in the lower block, only one pulley is there. The load is attached to this one. Load is acting vertically downward. Here there is a hook. Then we have to start the string from the, in the case of odd number, we have to start the string from the lower block. Tying the string here, that's hook. Then coming to this pulley, passing through the groove of this one. Then coming to the next one, passing through the groove and going to the groove of this one. You are applying the effort downward. Marking the tension opposite to the gravitational force. So this is the label diagram. Now we have to calculate the mechanical advantage of the system. So we have used the formula. Efficiency is equal to MA upon VR. So how much is efficiency? Efficiency is 80%. 80% means 80 upon 100. Mechanical advantage we have to find out. Velocity ratio is given as 3. So solving, mechanical advantage is equal to 8 into 3 divided by 10. 24 upon 10 is equal to 2.4. So this is the first part. So mechanical advantage is equal to 2.4. Now, the second part, the effort required to raise a load of 300 Newton. So, the effort required to raise a load of 300 Newton. Load is equal to 300 Newton. So, we write the formula. Mechanical advantage is equal to load upon effort. Mechanical advantage we have already found. 2.4. 424 by 10 equal to load is 300. Effort we have to find out. Then effort will come 300 into 10 divided by 24. So then this one 24 we got by using six fours are 24. Then 6 in 300 also we can cut by using 6 tables. 50. Then this 4 and 50 we cut by using 2 tables. 25 into 10, 250 by 2 equal to 125 Newton. So this is the solution of क्वेश्चन नंबर सिक्स. नाउ वी आर डूइंग क्वेश्चन नंबर नाइन. ए ब्लॉक एंड डायगनल सिस्टम हैज द वेलोसिटी रेशियो ऑफ 3. सो वेलोसिटी रेशियो इज इक्वल टू 3. Draw a label diagram of the pulley system. As I have already told you how to draw a block and diagonal system of 3 pulleys. In the upper block, 3 is an odd number. In that case, you have to make 2 pulleys in the upper block and 1 pulley in the lower block. I have already explained you, and I have already told you how to make a block and diagonal system of velocity ratio 3. So velocity ratio is equal to 3. Then a man can exert a pull of 200 kgf. So effort is equal to 200 kgf. What is the maximum load he can raise with this pulley system if the efficiency is 60%? Efficiency is equal to 60%. So we have to calculate load. Load we have to find it out. So first we calculate the mechanical advantage. Efficiency is equal to MA upon VR. So using the formula, efficiency is equal to mechanical advantage upon velocity ratio. We calculate the mechanical advantage. 60%, 60 upon 100, which is equal to mechanical advantage upon velocity ratio 3. Then mechanical advantage will come as 6 into 3 by 10, 18 by 10 equal to 1.8. Now in question it is asked to calculate the load. So we write this formula. Mechanical advantage is equal to load upon effort. Substituting the value of mechanical advantage, that is 18 by 10, which is equal to load upon effort. Effort is 200 kgf. Then solving, load equal to 18 into 200 kgf upon 10. So that is equal to 18 into 20. 360 kgf. This is the answer of first part. One more part is there, that next part is the effort moves through a distance of 60 centimeter. What distance does the load move? So displacement of effort is 60 centimeter. So displacement of second next part. Displacement of effort is equal to 60 centimeter. We have to find the displacement of load. We write this formula. Velocity ratio is equal to displacement of effort upon displacement of load. So velocity ratio is given as 3. 3 is equal to displacement of effort is 60 upon displacement of load. So displacement of load will come 60 divided by 3, which is equal to 20 centimeter. So this is the solution of this question. Next class we will discuss another topic.